nation me just a citizen me and say how and why. You know what, make we officially kick off the report. But Sef Nation, the entertainment feed community, Wagwan, we're up on the Saturday of Freestyle Saturdays. Early morning segment, people. Did want to start this much earlier, but unfortunately, we couldn't get to. But time around Nation, so make we quickly jump to the stories. Wanna know how we do it? First, the music. So, we're gonna kick off this one with the official music video for Skilly Bang's song titled Sloppy.
Been two girls, them a be bad full of years. I then I no behavior, latex hand. Them start do the danger, paint job. Go on, when me start come here, yeah.
Come on my face.
Sloppy, sloppy.
Dancehall artist Dovie Magnum last week was arrested by the US Immigration and Customs Enforcement on immigration issues. It was later revealed to our management team that the issue at hand was that of overstaying, and Dovie Magnum had retained legal counsel. Dovie, that not too sound like overstay. That sound more like live. Too many think overstay the live. But make we continue donation. Dovie Magnum was recently released from ICE. And as Dovie Magnum got released, Dovie Magnum released the song titled Never Fail.
Prayer never failed me yet. God never failed me yet. Prayer never failed me. The health and strength and daily breath. Cause prayer never failed me yet.
Version with the music video for a dream.
Watch out for them, watch out for who said that them like you. Watch out for them, watch out for them. No for them a paisa. No true them in a the picture, then that no say. Them create fake page, make bad comments, yeah.
Jeff Frost, drop the visuals for give thanks.
Thanks to all of this. Father God, me give thanks to all of this. Never born to me, my damn father rich. Glad so you show them, say I'm a papa this.
Despite all going on with Tamale Sparta still a dropping song them as the artist released the song titled All Depends.
Me say it all depends. Which idle man won't come cross the ends. Quick for murder, you will say a self-defense. Talk to me, cast step and watch your friend them take fence. It all depends. It all depends.
Shani released the official music video for the single titled Silly Move.
Feel we link and a walk over. War start up, can't talk over. One silly move of your life over. Kill two of them and go laugh over. Them feel me link and a walk over.
The Dancehall King and his family, of course, don't know who me attack. Dancehall artist Vibes Cartel released the official music video for the single titled Air Force One.
Dad, oh that's so bad. Air Force One, but like the jet plane, them the American presidents of.
Me feel hype like Jesus when he walk across the water, and me Air Force sneakers and the black one Obama.
Busy signal dep on the list too, as he released the visuals for Case.
Afi bus a case tonight. Girlfriend a request the love, cause she say it feel right. Afi bus a case tonight. Knock knock on her front door, so she let me inside.
Fast rising dancehall artist Yaxta set to release the song titled Assets.
Assets over hype, dog, them name three. True contribution at NHD. So me can qualify for your loan, yeah. Use that money and purchase a home. My plan serve as A, B and C. My granny old shop turn Airbnb.
L.A. Lewis, a Sikh worker, as the entertainer, no, me can't say entertainer. You know what? As the 7-star general recently shared this on his Instagram story. If anyone, and yes, people, that is anyone, me know someone wanna see it and probably I say Anthony, Anton or Anon or something like that. No, anyone. So make we continue. If you know anyone wants work, DM me, need someone to come weed up for me. You see what I go on nation. So if anybody out there will see that work and feel as if them can take it on, wanna go DM LA Lewis. LA Lewis need somebody to put in some work. But nation, that for now, we're moving on. This clip has been making rounds on social media and it has caused outrage. Check out the clip. Nation, wanna see what go on? The party shot. That one that recently took place in Negril. All I can say, pandemic COVID-19. Most clip with up on social media from the other day, we see that police are locked down some events. We see certain entertainers and public figures are arrested for staging events. But fuck it, we even see people lose all them teeth. And when we say lose them teeth, you know we Jamaicans at times when someone lose a tooth, we say teeth. Me not attack no tooth, me attack teeth. The man lose couple teeth well. And why the man now have to pay over all 400,000 for get two dental implants or just wear a couple dentures? because he was not wearing a mask, and the police then decided to tackle him and thump out man teeth. Lot of people been a cry, so the government need to free up a little, because the nightlife, the event planning and support, and put on event, I saw a lot of people make their money. But as the people them put on something, the police lucky don't back. People them just feel the pressure.
Under the pressure.
But over in a Rick's Cafe in a Negril, guess what?
Party shot like 116. Them call me the Raven King.
Beanie Man took it to Instagram where he stated this. And of course, you know Beanie Man was one of the entertainers prosecuted for breaching the Disaster Risk Management Act. Let me continue though. I guess my apology was not good enough. I am not above the law, but some people are. Hashtag Jamaica, hashtag double standard. The shaman at the comment section, the hypocrisy in Jamaica at its highest level, hashtag lockdown. Spraga Benz, we are all equal, but some animals are more equal than others. Beanie Man once again, dancehall continues to suffocate at the government hands, Beanie Man was say. But let me continue. Beanie Man once more, right now are the people who will lose them loved ones, we feel it for the people that were not allowed to bury their dead. But thousands of foreigners can forward and get approval to keep festival. Now fight the promoter of the event because them get go ahead from the officials. And yes, people, you hear Beanie Man main part, they saw thousands of foreigners basically get the go ahead for party. Nicky Z live. Listen, every promoter needs to hold a peaceful protest in every parish, same time, same day. Wola Jamaica together, free us up. Over on Bounty Killer page, Bounty Killer shared a piece of the article from Jamaica Star which states, Rick's Cafe apologizes for breaching COVID rules. Bounty Killer shared that with the caption stating this, at Andrew Olness, on a charge the pastor lady and also Beanie Man, who is a true ambassador for the country and its culture. We had a problem with that, but let's see what's gonna happen to Rick's Cafe now, if it's a triple standard thing aguana. When he even launched big investigation upon the Olympian hero, Usain Bolt, for a little small party gathering, comparing to this one week's event that was held. Poor people fed up. And little movie star Trevor also had to pay a big fine when the friends need to pay too. When the two wicked to jab people about ya. Being a man, one thing coronavirus show up in Jamaica, it's double standard and lack of respect for us as Jamaicans is at its peak, brother. Them say one video ads with me and a problem. And look ya now, 7-day festival them a promote on Jamaica Tourist Board. A flaw fire, them a suffocate with industry while foreign promoters get freedom to do what them want. Coolface the Notorious stated this, dancehall music turned Andrew into a household name and got him voters, and then he turned on dancehall music just like I predicted. I hope the music industry remembers this when they want dubs for election. And there are a lot more entertainers in the comment section, entertainers and public figures, but we just gonna skip past that for now and move to this. Rick's Cafe order closed as government does damage control over Mocha Fest. The Olness administration is in damage control mode on Friday as it faces growing public anger after videos surfaced showing some scores of patrons attending a party at Rick's Cafe in Negril, Westmoreland on Thursday. Criticism is mounting against the government even as state agencies scramble to take action against the operators of Rick's Cafe, and the Jamaica Tourist Board disassociated itself from the party, which was one of several events held this week by organizers of Mocha Fest. The events took place despite restrictions on public gatherings and the lockdown of the entertainment sector as part of measures to curb the spread of COVID-19. Local Government Minister Desmond McKenzie on Friday ordered the closure of Rick's Cafe. The closure will be for 7 days for breaches of the orders under the Disaster Risk Management Act. While Prime Minister Andrew Olness has stated an investigation is to be carried out to ensure government entities did not aid in lawbreaking in relation to Mocha Fest.
Government will have to ensure that it was not complicit in any breach of its own law, and I have asked for a report and my own investigations will be conducted. And the various arms of the state that have a duty to ensure the equal application of the law, I am expecting that they will move in that direction to ensure that if there is any breach, that the full application of the law will be guaranteed. It throws up something that we're always contending with in our society. The unequalness of the society, the haves and the have-nots. Why is it that some people are allowed to party and others are not? The unequal nature of the society. And this government has a duty to ensure that the law is equally applied, both to those who have not and those who have.
Tourism Minister Edmund Bartlett has issued a stern warning that breaches of COVID-19 protocols will not be tolerated in the tourism sector and on the resilient corridor that has had an international recognition because of the compliance level that we have had and the impeccable record of very, very low indeed instances, no infection whatsoever. He said his ministry will act immediately and firmly in relation to Rick's Cafe breach.
It is against that background that I'm deeply saddened by the fact that a breach was realized and we want to act immediately and firmly in relation to the Rick's Cafe breach. On my part as minister, I'm making it very clear that no activity whatsoever which breaches any element of the DMRA and indeed undermines the protocols that we've worked so hard to build and the corridor that has had international recognition because of the compliance level that we have had and the impeccable record of very, very low, indeed in instances, no infection whatsoever.
It's happened, and what I would suggest is that we use this to move forward in some way in terms of reopening the entertainment industry. Maybe we can learn some things from what happened here in an effort to get back on track, because Negril is missing entertainment, and you know, I know there are a lot of people suffering because of the lockdown, and we want them to get back to work as well. So in a safe way, obviously, in a safe way and within the law. How was it able to happen, and what precautions were taken, what was done to make it happen in a way like it did, and were there any breaches or any breakdown in protocols? You know, why that happened and what can be done to correct it.
Say here, Mago Andeso, why Rush took it to Instagram where he had this to say.
People, let me ask you now a question. You think if the people them never make up noise and take it to social media and a comment and a like and a share and a say hypocrisy this go on a mocha fest? When you think about being a man, when you think about all of the other show them, nobody can keep show. No ghetto youth, no promoter, no entertainer, no selector, nobody can eat food. People are get locked up for social distance. People are get police are lick out man teeth because them now wear mask. You understand? Yeah, we have to lock up and can't eat food. You don't think if Uno never go social media, the government would have comment on this and you'd hear about investigation? You think Prime Minister would have comment if Uno never make up noise about it? No. Answer me if I lie, me I tell. People know that Uno have the power. Uno complaints change this. Uno have the power, make up noise. Uno can change anything Uno want change overnight. Enough is enough. Remember that. People them have the power.
Nation, you see what time o'clock, you see what time o'clock, where Orion get the career. And as usual, my people.
And we immediately proceeded to the location. We directed that the operations should be closed down. But I would want to use this opportunity as well to say that on the arrival of the police, what was observed on social media, which I viewed myself, that was not what we actually saw. But we believe that we would have seen sufficient to prosecute. So the police acted immediately upon receiving that information. And the police will be vigilant within that particular space and appropriate action will be taken where breaches are observed. What I will say and what I would request of the citizens is that if they observe anything happening, call our 119 line. If you're calling the local police and you're not getting through for whatever reason, call 119 and pass on the information. And I guarantee you that appropriate action will be taken.
But
definition.
Wagwan.